All right, let's do another u substitution example. In this case, we have the antiderivative of the square root of tangent of x times secant squared x dx. It seems really complicated, and obviously you cannot use a normal antiderivative rule. You have to use u substitution. Now, I want you to think about your trig derivatives. What is the derivative of tangent? Okay, now secant squared, you are correct. And so that's going to give you a pretty good hint as to what your u is. Considering tangent is inside of the square root, that would lead you to believe that your u is tangent, plus the fact that the derivative of tangent is secant squared, you would get a cancelization here. You're going to set your u equal to tangent of x for step one, and that's because it's inside of the square root and the derivative of that is secant squared. Step two, you're going to take the derivative of u, so of your u equation in terms of take d dx of both sides, basically. So you're going to du dx equals secant squared. And again, for the next step, you have to get dx by itself. So you will cross-multiply normally. So cross-multiplying, you're going to get dx secant squared x equals du. For step three, get dx by itself. And then you'll divide both sides by secant squared. So you get du over secant squared x equals dx. Now you can see why you did that. When you replace tangent of x with u, you get square root of u, and then replace dx with du over secant squared x. Now you can see these secant squareds are going to cancel, and you're just going to get the antiderivative of square root of u times du. So for step five, once you simplify, you will see that this will be very easy to differentiate, especially when you make this u to the 1/2. So there's step six and seven will not be necessary because there are no x's. But to ensure that this is expression is antiderivable, I guess we will do step 7, just change square root of u to u to the 1/2. That way we can use the reverse power rule. So for step 8, when we take the antiderivative of u to the 1/2 is u to the 3/2 divided by 3/2, which is 2/3 u to the 3/2. Don't forget h plus c. And then for the final step, you will replace the u with what it was equal to, which was tangent of x. So for step 9, when you change u back in terms of x, you have 2/3 tangent of x to the 3/2. Which, you know, you could maybe rewrite in terms of radical form, but you don't have to. You can just leave it this way. Now we take the derivative for step 10 to check. We will use basically the power rule with the chain rule. And we get square root of tangent of x secant squared x dx, which is what we originally started with. So that concludes our lesson. And that lets us know for sure that antiderivative of our original function is indeed equal to 2/3 tangent of x to the 3/2 plus c. You could rewrite this, like I said before, as 2/3 square root of tangent cubed x plus c, and it will be the same answer. That's it for this example of u substitution. As you can see, the more you do it, the more comfortable you'll get with figuring out what u is, and it will become much easier. If you have any other questions about this example, let me know.